Oh my god. Hey, 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 how's it going, everybody? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So my name is fahimmuchi and I'm a vocal coach slash voice teacher. And today we got DARREN ESPANTO sings Fantasia's I Believe live on Wish 107.5 Bus. Now, I don't think I have reacted and analyzed this video before, but if I did, then please let me know in the comment section, because as you guys know, that I lost my main channel where I reacted over 450 videos, right? So I have to redo a couple of videos once again, because you know, y'all have been requesting me to do it. So yeah, so that's pretty much it. But I really, really don't feel like I have reacted to this before, but if I did, then let me know. But for now, without any further ado, let's just go ahead and jump right into this video.
Hello everyone, this is DARREN ESPANTO. Don't miss any Wish exclusive performances. Just click right here to subscribe.
He has a very good accent as well, compared with the other people that I've heard. Like, he sounds a lot American, right? So that's really good. This song is based... This song is based on G-sharp major key, okay?
Wow.
Oh, his phrasing. Oh my god. Oh my god, it's crazy. Listen for the way. Listen for that C5 from a B flat to a C, B flat 4 to a C5, right? Listen, look at his tongue. Oh, he's curling his tongue back, and that's where you get that kind of dark sound rather than If you keep the tip of the tongue behind the bottom teeth, which a lot of vocal teachers out there, advocates, then it will result in a brighter sound. And if you do what it's doing, the tongue is gonna curl back. That's what people mostly use in classical music. And in the like, you can hear that his tone has this kind of warm, mellow darkness to it, right? It almost sounds like a yell, but it's not, right? So in CVT terms, complete vocal technique, if you guys know what that is, it's curbing with a dark sound color. In other words, it's a mixed voice, yeah, but it's with a dark sound color. I wouldn't say, yeah, I think, I mean, it's a chesty dominant mixed voice. I mean, it can be a lot powerful. I mean, I've heard him sing more powerfully, but this one is more in that kind of dark sound color, okay? So that's why the sound kind of sounds like this. Hi, you see that? His tongue is very flat. You see that, how flat his tongue is in the mouth? Because he's using dark sound colors, and he's so good at that. Oh my god, listen for that phrase. You see? You know, like, just imitating this guy, like, if you can imitate him, like, with precise details, like from A to Z, you're gonna be a really, really good singer. Like, literally, as I'm listening to this guy, and I'm sorry for pausing so much, but this is the kind of people that I really like reacting and analyzing to, because they're so good with their phrasing. Like, you hear the voice, and you're like, oh my god, he sounds so good. It's just not about the range, you know what I mean? There are so many other elements in singing, such as your phrasing, intonation, rhythm, accent, vibrato and whatnot, fast runs and trills, and he's doing all that, and it just sounds so freaking good, yeah? Man, it is amazing.
When you look out in the distance, you'll see there was that heaven knows of your existence, and it's me, everything you are.
Nice. You can see that he's using a dark sound color, which sounds really freaking good.
There's a time for every soul to fly into the eyes of every child. It's the hope that love will save the world. No, we should never, let it go.
Oh my God. He's a diva, man. He's a little diva. Wow. T-Star 5 at the top. Wow. Oh my God, I'm gonna cry. You see how he's shaping his mouth? Look at his tongue. Because he's using a dark sound color, which is what the tongue is back. Like it's like that, not eh. Yeah? Look at his tongue. See that? Wow. Look at his tongue. It's way back there. Do you see that? Oh, nice. Pumping me up. I'm speechless. Oh my Lord. Oh my God. Let me go ahead and wrap this up and then I'll give you guys my analysis and some thoughts. Oh my God. Oh my God, guys. So what you just heard, that's like the peak level of music, of phrasing, I should say. Yes, that is a pop R&B song. I don't know the song, but I heard a lot of Whitney Houston and Mariah Carey influence. So I'm assuming it's one of their songs, maybe Whitney Houston or Mariah Carey. I'm not, obviously not both, but you get my idea. But dude, DARREN ESPANTO, like, do you guys have any idea how hard it is to sing the way he just did? Like, range is out of the equation. Like, forget the range. Like, the things he's doing with his phrasing, those intonations, those runs, the little trills and licks, the way he's shaping the vowels, the dark sounds, the way he... like he's curling his tongue back and like he's using those darker vowels to sing the song. How fluid he's going through his registers, like chest voice, mixed voice, head voice, like he's going through all that so effortlessly, so efficient. I mean, Dude, I can't analyze this. I mean, what I can say is that he's in a chesty mixed vest coordination and then he flips into a falsetto or head voice kind of coordination. But dude, like, if you want to learn how to sing like that, you have to imitate, like, literally phrase by phrase. Take a 3-second phrase, see what it's doing there. Like, for instance, like, if I break it down for you, just a sec. So for instance, that part. Ever catch the shooting. Like, you gotta really break it down. Like, stop. Like, you said it, stop. You gotta. It's very hard, and obviously, I'm not even half as good as what he's doing, clearly.
And tell me how.
Like you don't learn that with mum, 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 mum. You don't learn that, those stuffs with that. Those exercises are only helpful for range building, right? But these types of stuff, you gotta really, really listen for the little details, the little subtleties that he's doing, how he's signal pitting the notes and whatnot. And it's very hard. If you already don't have a good sound in your singing, then teaching these things is quite complicated. Like, you gotta really have really good listening skills. You need to develop your hearing skills. So yeah. I mean, like, I got so much emotional at the end, I couldn't even speak. Like, my voice was literally shutting me down. It was so freaking good. And this is, ladies and gentlemen, what you just witnessed. That's the peak level of singing. Like, for real. Okay? DARREN ESPANTO is an absolutely brilliant vocalist. Like, the way that he sang those notes, the way that he sang even the lower notes, the mid notes and whatnot, that is very hard to teach, man. That is very, very hard to teach. Like, there's so many subtleties, so many nuances, so many fast licks and trills and runs. That's quite hard to do. I mean, wow. I'm burping. I'm just too excited, man. Like, his phrasing is at the peak level, okay? And I'm assuming that it's probably a Mariah Carey or a Whitney Houston song, because I heard a lot of those women's influences in his voice. If I'm not, then please correct me. But listen to the phrasing, okay? So let's take one part here. So let's go here.
Have you ever reached?
So these kinds of fast 3 notes run, 4 notes run, these are very hard to teach. Like, a lot of people can hear it, but they can't do it. And for that, you have to really practice, man. You have to practice without a song, with the song, make it sound good and whatnot. So let's continue again. You see that? That's vibrato. Listen for the phrasing.
And in fine. You're proud of all.
Right? How many vibratos, the run. It's like these kinds of things, you only learn that by listening to the song, really paying attention, really developing your ear skill, man. I mean, just listen.
Ever catch the shooting?
And then falsetto.
Stop.
Right? It's very syncopated.
And tell me how I.
Right? So smooth, so frequent. Like, you gotta, like, if you want to sound like that, if you want that type of a sound, you have to really, really, really learn the phrasing by listening to that over and over, okay? So now, let's get to the chorus a little bit. So like, he's using a lot of dark vowels. Wait, look at his tongue. Look at his tongue, you see that? Yeah, so like, there's a lot of A-I-E. So like, he's kind of curling his tongue back because he chose to sing with a darker sound color. So that's why the sound, like, if I do E, you said that naturally that sounds darker, like that, when the tip of the tongue is not resting behind the bottom teeth. That would usually lead to a darker sound. Classical singers usually tend to use that, yeah, mostly. Yeah, like, honestly, I'm speechless at this point, and, you know, I can't really break it down, man. Like I said earlier, a few minutes ago, that you really gotta listen to the details. You really gotta listen, imitate, and see what you're doing wrong, fix it, get the vowels the way he's doing it and whatnot. That's the only way you're gonna get the sound, man. So I really don't want to make this video very long, so I'm just gonna leave it here because I'm so speechless and I'm blown away by this dude. So there you go, guys. That's my reaction and my vocal analysis of Darren Espanto sings Fantasia, I Believe, live on Wishbone Espanto 5. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you guys learned something from this video, because if you did, then please don't forget to give this video a big old thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the notification bell if you haven't already. Let me know in the comment section about your thoughts about my reaction and my analysis, and if you guys have any song suggestions, whether it's from Wish107.5 or anybody else, then please leave them in the comment section and I will get back to you as soon as I can. I have a Facebook page and an Instagram account where I try to share my videos of my own personal singing, as well as me coaching other people out there and helping them with their singing and whatnot. So I would really, really appreciate if you can go and give my Facebook page a like and follow me on my Instagram. I could really use the support. Last but not least, if you guys have any questions about your own vocal technique or singing or anything in general, or if you want voice lessons from me, then you can either email me at fahimmuchifreelance1@gmail.com, which I will leave on the description, or you can book a lesson with me at my Fiverr account, which I will also leave a link on the description, yeah? So, yep, that's pretty much it for this video. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.